Good evening, friends. Nice to see you this evening. And it's my pleasure to share with you today's topic on transformation of our minds, a new life in Christ. Before I begin, it reminds me of the song that we heard and we sing and we dance at a wedding reception or for a birthday party, the hokey pokey, where we say, put your right hand in, put your right hand out, put your and turn yourself around and do the hokey pokey, then you put your left hand in and left hand out, and then you say, put your right hand, put your right side in and put your right side, and it goes on till the end. And the last verse is, put your whole self in and put your whole self out. And that is what today Saint Paul speaks about. The transformation in our lives comes, and in order to we need to be transformed, we need to be not to be conformed to the things of this world. We need to be transformed because we have to live a new life in Christ. Now this chapter 12 is a very interesting chapter for me also in my personal life, and not only in my life but in the life of many saints. For example, Saint John Chrysostom, who is also called the golden truth of the Catholic Church. He was a fantastic preacher, he was an orator, and he would dwell a lot on this book of Romans, letter to the Romans. It is said that he read for 18 years the book of Romans, that is, once a week, one day of a week, he would read all the weeks of the year for 18 years, he would read the full of the letter of Romans, right from chapter 1 till the end. So much love he had for this word. Secondly, we have another saint, Saint Augustine, who was, we know about this great saint, who was a doctor of the church, and he has written a lot of teachings in the church. He was living in his initial stages. When he was a young man, he was living an immoral life, and somebody placed the Bible in his hand, the New Testament, and he was sitting under a tree as a young lad, and he was thinking about his future. And there he was so desperate and anxious and worried about his life that there were a group of children around there around the place where he was sitting on the tree, and they were singing, pick up and read. They were singing a song, not for him, but there some song they were singing, and Augustine felt that song was for him. So he picked up the New Testament and he began to read. And as he was flipping the pages of the New Testament, the Spirit led him to chapter 13, verse 12 to 14. I want to read this to you. And it reads like this, Romans chapter 13, verse 12. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify itself. After reading on this, after meditating or contemplating on these words, Saint Augustine changed his mind. There was a transformation in his mind. He was conformed to the things of this world and he got transformed into a new life after reading the scriptures. My dear friends, before we really begin and dive into Romans chapter 12, verse 2, I would like to read verse 1, where Saint Paul says, I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercy of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. We do a lot of worship, we do singing and we do dancing, we do clapping, we play. That is music, that is worship. But he talks about a spiritual worship which is pleasing to him, is offering our life to him. So, the verse 2 speaks about, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by renewing of your mind, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good, what is acceptable, and what is perfect and pleasing to him. Now the question is, the main crux of this verse is that we need to discern what God's will is for you and for me. And therefore, in order to know God's will, we need to transform our minds and not to be conformed to the things of this world, not to be attached to the things of this world. We are not to live according to the standard of this world or according to this age, but we need to transform our minds and look towards the heavenly things. And so, my dear friends, I would compare and illustrate this whole thing in two simple words. Remember, a thermometer and a thermostat. Now, the thermometer is something like the people who are confirmed to the things of this world, who are attached to the world. Now, the thermometer depends on the things around it, the temperature around it. So, it can do nothing by itself, but it shows results by the things around it. But a person who is transformed is like a thermostat. You know, the thermostat is something that is placed in an AC or into your fridge, where you can turn the knob and adjust your temperature accordingly, whether you want cold or little much cooler or very cold. And that is what I called a believer, a Christian. A transformed Christian is like a thermostat. He doesn't depend on the things around him, but the things around him depend on the person, that the believer. And such person, I would say, is a thermostat. And therefore, my dear friends, a thermostat, Jesus therefore says, is like a salt of the earth, a light of this world. And therefore, Jesus says in the Gospel of Luke, that be the light. Let your light shine among men so that they may see the good works in you and glorify the Lord. And therefore, we have to be transformed people. We need to be transforming our minds. To be transformed people, we need to do two things. You need to change your thoughts. You need to change your pattern of thinking. And the second thing is that we need to look at the heavenly things. So coming back to the first one, renewal of mind means seeking the truth. What is truth? To read the word of God. Jesus is the word. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the way and the life, and I am the truth. So Jesus is the word. We need to know Jesus more. We need to be like Jesus. That reminds me of an incident when I went to a Gulf country about 10 years ago. I met a fantastic man, a man who's a preacher, evangelizing all over the place. He goes all over the world. And when he came to India, I met him 11 years ago. And there he said, whenever you come to Gulf, you must meet me. So when I went there and I made sure I went and met him. And as we were talking to one another, and after a long conversation was over, we discussed about our ministries. And finally we said, let's pray for one another. And so I asked him to pray over me. So he prayed. So he asked me, what do you want me to pray for? I gave him a long list of what are my needs, and he prayed over me. And then I asked him, what do you want me to pray for you? And he said, just four words. And I was very impressed. I was amazed at those four words. He says, make me like Jesus. He said, pray that I may be like Jesus. And that words, it is just almost imprinted on my heart. Make me like Jesus. That is what is transformation. He was asking for a transformation. And so we need to seek the truth. And so what is seeking the truth? We will know the truth only when we read the scriptures. For example, people say that you will never be loved. But the truth is, the Bible says in Jeremiah 31 verse 3, says, I have loved you with an everlasting life. People will say, it's not possible with you. You will never be able to do it. But Philippians chapter 4, 13, the truth, the Bible says that you can do all things to Christ Jesus who strengthens you. There are some people who will say, nothing is not possible for you. You are not capable at all. But the word of God says in Luke chapter 1, 37, with God, nothing is impossible. There were things, you know, God looks at you differently. He knew you before the foundation of this earth. He knew you even before the world was made. Even before he could form you in your mother's womb, he had already thought a plan for you. And God's plan for you is very special. And there is a purpose for you in your life. God has created us in such a way, he has made us in his own image and likeness, that we may become useful instruments of his. My dear friends, the people, when they saw that Samaritan woman, or rather the disciples who were with Jesus, saw the Samaritan woman at the well, and They were suspicious about her, but Jesus never looked at her with suspicion. He always thought that she would be an evangelizer. She would carry the word. And in fact, after meeting Jesus at the well, she went about telling in the village, in the village of Samaria, that I have found the Messiah. I have found the man that we are looking for. Jesus, let's take about Peter. Peter denied Jesus 3 times. And the people would say, oh yes, denied Jesus. But Jesus, though he denied Jesus, Jesus had a big plan for Peter to make it the first one. There was this lady who was an adulterous woman in John chapter 8, and people wanted to stone her to death, but Jesus saw something beautiful in her. He says, get up, daughter, and do sin no more. Jesus always sees something beautiful in each one of us. And therefore, the first thing is we need to know who we are. That is, we need to seek the truth that we are very special. We are instruments of God. We are His ambassadors. We have won victory in Him. We are His masterpiece. And so this seeking the truth will come first thing by reading the Word of God. And the second thing we need to do is, in order to transform our lives, is we need to focus our thoughts on the things heavenly. Like St. Paul says in Colossians chapter 3, he speaks about, he says, keep our focus on the heavenly things. Not on things that are on earth, for you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. My dear friends, we need to keep our focus on the things that are heavenly. I know of a gentleman who's a big businessman. He's a supplier of ventilators in Bombay, and he's a great donator of the church. He donates a lot to the people, to the church, and particularly to the poor people. And I know that he has been contributing large sums of money. He says, you know, Deacon Everest, I'm not able to preach like you. I'm not able to go and evangelize. I can't do much in the church, but I do my services helping the poor. I donate. And he said one thing to me, and it touched me. He says, I am building the kingdom of God by my wealth. And so therefore, he's investing his wealth for the kingdom of God. He's already preparing treasures for him in heaven. My dear friends, and therefore Jesus says in Matthew chapter 6 verse 21, wherever your treasure is there will be your heart. And also he says, lay your treasures in heaven in verse 20. Lay your treasures in heaven. My dear friends, today let us realize and let us come back to the Lord and say, Lord, we don't want to be conformed to the things of this world. We want to be transformed. Help us to transform our lives. That reminds me of a retreat when I came to the Lord in 1996. In the year 1996, I came to the Lord first, one in my family, and then followed my wife, and then my children. That time my children were too small. And in 1997, soon after a year, we went to Hyderabad for a retreat, and there was a 5-day retreat. And I saw many people were getting healed and miracles and wonders happening, and there was nothing happening to me. I could not find anything, you know, something spectacular happening, and I was waiting to also give a witness to what is happening there. Many people are going on the stage and sharing their testimonies. I wanted to share, but I had nothing to share. And on the last day, there was a 3-hour mass, and the priest was Father Christuraj. I would like to mention his name. He started his own congregation today. And Father Christuraj said a 3-hour mass. And in that mass, during communion, as I was going for communion, and I received the communion, and I was turning there and coming back to my place, there was a choir there singing, "Change My Heart, O Lord." And when I was passing there, the next verse started, "Change My Thoughts, O Lord." And that, when I got that word in my mind, printed in my mind, and when I came to the seat, I began reflecting, "Change My Thoughts, O Lord." Every time I heard this hymn, "No, change my heart, change my mind, change my life," but I had never heard this word, "Change My Thoughts." And immediately I went to my seat there after communion, and I was reflecting, what is it that I need to change? And there was a lot of unforgiveness in me towards certain people. And then I realized that if they want, there has to be a miracle in my life, if there is a change, has to be a change in my life, if I want to have new life in my life, I need to forgive those people. And immediately went on my knees and asked for forgiveness. I forgave those persons and I asked the Lord to give me the grace to forgive people. And from then on till today, by God's grace, I'm able to immediately forgive people for whatever they do against me. And therefore, my dear friends, today I make an appeal to you that we need to change our lives. And how do we change our lives? By not to be conformed to the things of this world. And therefore, we need to be detached to the things of this world and to be attached to God. We need to be unplugged from the things of this world and to be plugged into the heart of Jesus. Let's come this evening in prayer as we join our hands and we close our eyes and we ask the Lord to bless us. Father God, this evening we thank and bless you for this beautiful moment of grace. Thank you, Father, for giving us the grace to come for this prayer meeting, to listen to your word, that you want us to be a sacrifice for you, O God. A spiritual worship is by giving ourselves to you, by giving our bodies to you, our entire selves to you. And Lord Jesus, we want to understand your will for us and help us not to be conformed to the pattern, to the standard of this age and to this world, but we may transform our minds by the transformation of our minds, by the transformation of our thoughts, that we may be able to understand your will for us, which will be acceptable to you, will be pleasant to you, and will be good to you. Lord, help us to be detached from the things of this world, to be unplugged from the things of this world, and to be attached to your heart. Fill us with the power of your Holy Spirit. Let your Holy Spirit come upon us, change our lives, change our minds, change our thoughts. Change my thoughts, O Lord, make it ever new. Change my thoughts, O Lord, may I be like you. You are the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me, this is what I pray. Change my life, O Lord, make it ever new. Change my life, O Lord, may I be like you. God bless you. Amen.